IK Multimedia just released their T-Rex Space Delay, a rather obvious emulation of the Roland RE-201 Space Echo. We'll go over the sound, how it works, and if it's worth buying. I'm Marlon and welcome to the White Noise Studio. Make sure to subscribe and hit that notification bell so you won't miss out on any new video. So the T-Rex Space Delay is an emulation of the Roland RE-201 Space Echo and can be used inside the T-Rex software or inside your DAW as a plugin. There are plenty of emulations of this specific tape delay around, and for me it comes down to 3 points. Does it have the tape vibe? Does it feedback nicely and hopefully drive into self-oscillation? Does it have some features non-existent on the original which makes it worth checking out? Let's find out. Here's the space delay. First thing you'll notice, it's red instead of the green of the Roland Space Echo. They are not much control to go over since Space Echo type delays are pretty simple to use. If you have never used a Space Echo tape delay, it works like this. The number of playheads of the tape delay determine the delay, which is a fixed ratio between the heads. The timing of the delay is created by changing which speed the tape plays. On this plugin, you set it by the rate knob, and you can see in the head's time display to which delay in milliseconds the delays are. The tape delay plugin has a switch for sync, which sets the timing into note values in sync with the project speed or milliseconds. That's a useful added feature. And a true emulation of the Roland Space Echo also has the mode function, as you can see here. This enables basically different combinations of turning on and off the tape playheads and the spring reverb of the unit. IK Multimedia included a table in the manual to see which mode is which combination. A little note on the manual. There is not a separate manual for the space delay. You have to open the T-Rex manual, and the space delay is on page 152. You can also see which playheads are active in the head's panning settings, which also allows you to set where each delay is in the stereo image. Another added function which is useful. Further added functions I want to point out which are not on the original Roland Space Echo are the panning of reverb and tape delay, the dry wet control, and basically most of this whole section here. It has a filter section with which you can filter the wet signal going into the effect unit. This is the stereo flip switch, which lets you use it in mono or stereo. The original Space Echo is mono. You can add noise if you fancy that, and you can change the character of the tape emulation. New is cleanest, and the more you dial it in to the old section, the more artifacts like wow, flutter, change in EQ and saturation are introduced. You can change more of the tape sound by using the docking, which emulates the loss of volume in the tape delay. So for the tape vibe and new features, this plugin already ticks the boxes. So how about the all-important self-oscillation? Well, just hear it. No doubt, this self-oscillates like a champ. As with the original unit, you can drive the input, which will change the tone of the unit, and most importantly, especially if you like dub-like delays as on this track, is this FX feed switch, also known as the dub switch. It cuts the incoming signal to the tape delay, which allows you to enable to create typical dub effects. So it basically turns the send to the effects on or off. The T-Rex Space Delay emulates a Roland Space Echo rather nicely. I'm not really interested if it does a one-on-one emulation. It absolutely has the vibe of a Space Echo. And it has useful enhancements to make it work in the modern DAW age. If you check it, for instance, with the Audio Damage Dubstation 2, check my review here, The Space Delay is much more vibey and truer to the original. The pricing of the Space Delay is, in my opinion, rather steep. There are way cheaper alternatives, like for instance the Dubstation 2. And if you're only interested in the T-Rex Space Delay, you still have to download the entire T-Rex software package, which is 1.5 GB big. There's a trial of 9 days. I recommend you check it out. The link is in the description below. Check out the videos displayed on screen right now if you're interested in more interesting delay plugins. Thank you for watching. I'm Marlon and this is the White Noise Studio. I'll see you in the next one. Bye.